receive the football. And a great day of football across the ESPN networks kicks off. And here is Geis on the return for LSU. Geis past the 25-yard line. Darius Geis, the sophomore tailback. And a pass play, a deep shot here to Dupree on the first play. And it's a terrific grab. Malachi Dupree, junior.
Who's replacing the injured Trumaine Washington. Now they'll run Geis here on first down in Louisville territory. And Geis turns it upfield and gets a feature player. Rush for 285 yards against Texas A&M. Straight ahead, big hole, and a first down for Geis. Six of Louisville. And here's Geis again. Dropped at the 22-yard line. After a game, is now in at running back. He's 235 pounds. Instead, Etling to throw, and the pass batted down. Incomplete. He was going for... Now on third down, Etling to the air, has time, and the pass is high, but it is incomplete. 13th attempt of the season, and this one not even close. He totally ripped it wide to the left. And they're just going to hand it off here on first down to Radcliffe. Nice move by Radcliffe, and he picks up a first down, gaining 12 yards. True freshman, his first pass of the day, and a ton of time. Bumps into his own guy. Brought down at the 36, but it's out. And Jackson bottled up here. Gain of one. It's Duke Riley. A delayed blitz here as Jackson dumps it off and Bonifon gets lit up. Incomplete. Dante Jackson with
one so far.
That's an incredible stat because you think that'd be one of the easiest throws.
Short punt. Oh, White misjudged it. Did it hit him? They ruled that it did not, but it's still down at the 5-yard line. And so Ellis, Louisville backed up on its 5-yard line for the second possession. Oh, Geis in trouble in the backfield and brought down.
Pat coordinator.
Yeah, he's from Pitt as Geis runs straight ahead past the 10 and upended at the 13 by Chucky Williams. On third and short, Louisville able to hit Geis at the line of scrimmage. Now, Geis fell forward, but I think he's short. Yep, they're going to mark it.
Malone just not able to keep leverage.
Groudon punt. Fielded at the 42. Alexander, no shot. Well, LSU with great speed. It was Donnie Alexanderson setting up. Going to take a shot here. And he has a man. It's caught inside the 10 by Quick. First and goal, Louisville. And a design run here for Jackson. Brought down after a gain of one. Play action. Jackson rolling out. Fires back to the near side. Incomplete. Trying to hit box. Instead, Jackson throws. Batted in the air and incomplete.
Shield coverage by the corner.
And Creakey gives Louisville the lead with a 24-yard field goal. LSU field goal try. That kickoff goes into the end zone for a touchback. He's done that to everybody this year. The number one offense, as Etling now is going to let it fly. And wide open is Dupree. Pass midfield and to the 49. 26.
Forces you to play on islands in the secondary, too, against their wide receivers.
Off play action. Etling in trouble. And down he goes. Back at the 36. It's Devontae Fields. Fields turns around and yells to the quarterback, look out. Second and 25 after the 15-yard loss. LSU trying to run the ball, and Williams brought down by third and 24. Etling looking for somebody, and it is incomplete. Intended
Pete. If you watch him this year, it's obvious.
Oh, Louisville almost got that. Instead, drilled the punter. The kick will go into the end zone. But remember now,
to the kicker. Receiving team, number 11. 5-yard penalty. Replay, fourth down.
You're likely going to get good field position because your defense just got to stop.
That hit a Louisville player, but it's recovered by the Cardinals at the 25. It got the backside.
In the second semifinal, it's just hard to pick against Urban Meyer in that situation.
Jackson in trouble. And he sacked at the 6-yard line. True freshman Devin White there for LSU.
Big play.
For his first sack of the season. Now Jackson gets outside here. He stumbled, tried to hurdle. And LSU, third and 21. Jackson drilled as he throws. Incomplete. Again, pressure. Punt from his 1 yard line. White trying to shield the sun. Remember, he had trouble with the first one. Has trouble with this one, but able to hang on to the ball. And White is free. This guy's dangerous with the ball in his hands. Out of bounds near the 50-yard line. Manning throws complete to Dupree. First down to the 40 and to the 34. Just to finish up on the Tre'Davious White. First down on the 34 for LSU. Here's Geis. And Geis with another outstanding run. Just short of another first down. Chuck.
Defense number 97 in the neutral zone with contact. 5 yard penalty results in a first down.
Here he is off the left side on second down and doesn't get anything. Second and 9, they run Geis between the tackles and he pushes the pile to the 16 yard.
Another running back.
Edling to throw on third down, dumps it off to Geis, and Geis able to break a tackle and get the first down and more. What a run. Man, how many times have we seen Leonard Fournette face? First and goal for the Tigers. It's Geis again. Geis with great effort after contact again to the 1 yard line.
Second down and probably come back and try to run it on third down. So Louisville's defense got to be aware of that.
They got three tight ends in the game. It is a pass play. Etling has a wide open man. An easy touchdown. Colin Jeter. First touchdown catch.
Fullbacks will be going in and trying to chalk block the end man on the line of scrimmage, and you sneak that corner. First downfield, but also if he were to escape to some open space.
Cameron Gamble kicking off, and Samuel will take a knee. So Lamar Jackson down for the 25, and they're going to run Jeremy Smith. Nowhere to go. Gain of a yard. Win for Florida State. Here's Lamar Jackson on second down. And he gets a handful. Here is Lamar. Rushed out of the pocket. Nowhere to go. Pushed out of bounds.
It's so fun to be around. Just so tragic to get the news several weeks back.
And the fair catch made to the 21. His ability to motivate as they run Darius Geis here on first down.
Can't help your team. You shouldn't be out there.
Here's Etling. Going downfield, and he throws it out of bounds incomplete.
Certainly understand
if coaches are allowed to do it, players should be allowed to do it as well. Etling, somehow that pass isn't picked off by Alex. To, if they so choose, not play. Geis straight ahead, bottled up after a
shot.
Big hit on Geis in the backfield by Grenard. He'll lose it.
Game that supposedly meant nothing got drafted third overall. So I think that you can still gain a lot from playing in a bowl game.
What a catch! Dupree with one hand snares it. What an impact.
Result of the play is a first down. After the play, unsportsmanlike conduct. Offense number 15, taunting. 15-yard penalty, first down and 10. This is number 15, first unsportsmanlike conduct foul of the game.
And if you get two, you're at the defender. Elling pumps, now takes off and runs past the 45. Geis, and nowhere to go in the backfield. To meet. Tom saw it Under Armour practices this week here in Orlando. Second and 11, Etling, eluding pressure, and throws it out of bounds. Pressure from Louisville. Etling throwing deep, underthrown. It's caught anyway. The helmet comes off of DJ Chark as he makes the catch. There was interference.
Interference, defense, that penalty is declined. The result of the play is a first down. Number 82 of the offense, his helmet came off. He has to stay out of the game for one play.
Complete, consistent receiver this year.
The pitch to Geis, and a beautiful tackle in the open field there. Geis again on second down, comes up short of the goal line. Play action. Etling dumping it off to Geis. He's in, touchdown! Delahousse on for the point after. And he just gets it through. The 3 yard strike. Plus, he only has 7 carries, negative 3 yards. A big sack didn't help, though. Liner taken by Travion Samuel. And he can't make it. Jackson in trouble again. Just had no shot.
And not played well to this point.
Here's Radcliffe finding some running room off the left side to get a chunk of it back. And they run it here on third down and eight, and knocked down in the backfield is Radcliffe. Here's White backing up to his 27. He jumps over a Louisville player and is to the 40 to take over with very good field position. And it's a play action pass. Etling looking to go downtown. And there's some miss
today. Losing two of their last three. He's off to a good start so far. His team is motivated and ready to play.
Geis with great. Third down and four. Etling in the pocket. Throws wide of the intended target. In this game. Snap was a little bit high, but the punt is away. And this will work out okay for Louisville starting around its 20.
A more complete player.
Jackson keeps it here and throws underneath complete to the
we've ever seen.
Jackson to run here. And boy, look at the speed of Jamal Adams. Adams perhaps playing his final college game. He's a junior.
There shows you what he's capable of.
Jackson to throw on third down and another sack.
This point, they've only attempted six throws. And we're almost through the first half. One thing about this Louisville offense, though, very streaky. They can get going in a heartbeat. If you don't believe it, it's been so dynamic so far.
Etling. Dupree is open to the 50-yard line. Another pass play here for Etling. And he's going for Dupree down the sideline. Incomplete. Jair out to the air again. Etling. It's a screen to Geis and an excellent play.
6 foot, about 5'11", 3'10".
Third and 12, Etling chased out of the pocket and throws it away. Louisville has. Don't even know if he's had a target in this game. Another short punt, an immediate penalty flag as well, and the ball will be placed.
Kicking team, 10-yard penalty. It'll be Louisville's ball, first down and 10.
Lamar Jackson on first down, throwing from his end zone, and boy, Godchow almost picked that off. And right now, he's at about 40. Here he is on second down. Off target again in threat. Jackson, oh boy, safety, drilled in the end zone by Arden Key. Again, the quarterback.
Kendall Beckwith, he's absent and you haven't even noticed.
Boy, I'm surprised Geis let that go instead of going and fielding it immediately. That's a mistake. He's past the 20-yard line of the 22. First down from their 23-yard line. Etling will throw it here. And he just throws it up for grabs, and it's picked off at the 32-yard line. What a mistake. Cannon with...
Jackson's going to stand, no doubt about it. That's exactly what I'm talking about.
Jackson's passed away off the mark. It's almost like...
...which creates inaccurate passes.
Jackson on second down. Going to the end zone. Again, overthrew his receiver. Who is open?
It's game.
Jackson on third down, escapes one Tiger, now darts forward, and finally brought down at the 30-yard line. Now, they're field
freaky.
And he nails it. ...made offensively, and if they'll have an impact on the game, they're going to get the ball to start the second half. And Alexander didn't realize, or Samuel rather, that he was not in the end zone. And boy, did he pay for it. He gets drilled. Has to start back near its 13-yard line. Jackson hit again. Walloped by Arden Key inside the 10.
Every time.
So they just run the ball here, and Smith planted. After only down 10 points in the game, Jackson to his left. And he's going to keep it here. Get past the 20 and close to the first down. They spot him.
Down. This play is now under replay review. This was a booth, replay booth initiated. Stop it.
Did.
Got over the top.
Looks like he's short there, though, doesn't it?
Looks like he's on the body. You can see the left elbow hitting the ground right before the 20.
The runner was short of the first down. It'll be fourth down and half a yard. At the 22-and-a-half-yard line.
Fiddling for Bobby Petrino.
So Mason King to punt here at fourth and one. Tre'Davious White is deep. White has a punt return for a touchdown this season, three for his career. White immediately signaling for the fair catch, and he's got it at the 31.
His consistency within his personality.
The defending national champs beat Clemson in the title game a year ago. Here's Geis on first down. They grab him at the ankles, but he keeps the feet.
Just incredible.
1,300 yards in the season for Geis. Here's Etling throwing. It's tipped in the air. Incomplete. Penalty marker down. They may not have gotten the playoff in time.
Offense, 5-yard penalty, third down.
For LSU. LSU brings pressure. Etling gets hit as he throws. Incomplete. So the card
to find an open LSU Tiger.
Good punt, backing up and over the head of Alexander, but he made the fair catch signal. It'll be
this field playing against Michigan State.
Jackson gets the first down past the 30 to the 32. Down on the 32-yard line. And Jackson again able to slip a tackle up to the 39-yard line. So that's a 7-yard pickup for him. He'll throw here on second down and three. Pumps in trouble again and is sacked again.
Use my legs and escape north and south.
On third and five, they'll take a shot here down the field. It's broken up by White. Incomplete.
Difficult to complete balls against.
They've had so many great defensive backs at LSU, and White expected to have a terrific NFL career. He can return punts. He's got three career touchdowns, looking for running room here. And instead, he's a punt return. Could need some help getting to the sideline. We'll see if he's back in on defense. Here's Darius Geis off the left edge, past the 25, and dragged down.
This Louisville defense.
72 rushing yards for Geis on the day. Got a couple games with over 250 this year. Here he is again, breaking free. Geis past midfield. Geis inside the 20. They won't catch him. Touchdown, LSU.
The play resulted in a touchdown. After the play, unsportsmanlike conduct, LSU. That 15-yard penalty will be enforced on the kickoff.
Enjoy the experience of playing college football.
Delahousse puts it through. 23-6 LSU. Changed his number to number 14, kicking off. And Samuel tried to let it go out of bounds. It didn't. That's a live ball. Scoops up on his 10 and steps out of bounds. Hey, everything going wrong. You saw Geis this year as Radcliffe is tackled.
He's going to be a Heisman contender.
Here's Jackson looking for somebody. Gets out of there. And does a great job to get 5 yards.
Just haven't had any rhythm offensively.
And now you get a drop, which would have been a first down.
That's 2.5 quarters.
Tre'Davious White, okay. He stays in the game here to return this punt. He got drilled on the last one. Signals for the fair catch here around the 40-yard line.
Believable by LSU defensively.
Here's J.D. Moore, the fullback, making the catch. There's a penalty flag thrown in the backfield for roughing the
passer. Defense number 55. 15-yard penalty added to the end of the play. Automatic first down.
What he's done with this collective group of talent this year has been truly exceptional.
Here's Williams to the 40. Now the other thing. Here's Darrell Williams, brought down at the 38-yard line. On third and five, Etling. And it's a first down grab for Chark
on the perimeter.
Here's Darius Geis. And Louisville's got him in the backfield. Here's Geis again on second down. And spun forward to the LSU is 6 of 12 on third down. They'll keep it on the ground here. And Geis is tackled at the line of scrimmage.
And center it up for his field goal kicker, Delahousse.
From 42 yards, and he splits the uprights to make it 20. Lamar Jackson won the Heisman Trophy. Took a gunshot wound to the elbow. Here's Seth Dawkins on the return for Louisville, trying to get the corner. And one of the better returns from the other side in Jalen Hurts, who has not looked like a true freshman this year. Jackson finds Hikatini. Is
right back to you. That's a veteran play for the sophomore.
Running straight ahead is Jeremy Smith up to the 49. Jackson keeps it here and gets a first down to the 44-yard line. Jackson sidearms it complete. James Quick showing quick feet to the 25-yard line.
Between Alabama and Washington.
Jackson trying to show off his talent. And again, the ball's on the ground. Hikatini could not come.
Great pass breakup.
Jackson in trouble. Another drop. Boy, he did a good job. 0 for 11 on third down. Here's Jackson running it, and he stumbles. But that's a good pass. It's a play fake and a pass that's caught for a first down.
Louisville, outstanding fake. When they get in that I formation, they like to run it right up the pike.
That time, the 15-yard line. Design run for Jackson. He's mauled. Play action. Jackson rolling out. Now throws. Tipped. Incomplete. Nearly picked off. Knowing they're in four-down territory. Oh, Jackson will throw it. Oh, an open man and another drop. Wow. Still down three possessions. But it's good. Giving. Here's Geis from the two for LSU. Got two touchdowns today, one on the ground, one receiving. And here he goes on the kick return. Oh, and he just slams the kicker to the ground and steps out of bounds.
But my goodness.
Off to right now on the sideline. First down for LSU in Louisville territory. They run Darryl.
Nice job today.
So did Julio at least give you props for that block?
Absolutely not. He said, I set it up for you. I said, you're right.
Etlin throwing a deep ball. Incomplete, but a flag. Intended for DJ.
Defense, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
And check that. It's Zykesis Cannon, who actually had left the game earlier and now is. Darryl Williams is in at running back, had 40 carries all season coming into today. Dupree on the catch. Etling to throw, going to the fullback, J.D. Moore. And Moore has a first down. Greg, you said
they have a lot of talent as well.
Yeah, they do. And really, if you're an LSU fan, that's what you wanted to see. You want to see the quarterback position address as we see another handoff here. But the two quarterbacks,
6 years, some by way of injury, some by way of poor play. No consistency at that position.
Etling lobbing one, and the receiver got held. DJ Chark, so this will be another look.
Spot foul, automatic first down.
That's on Alexander. Play fake. Etling just throws it into the dirt.
Well, you come in being flexible, thinking I'm going to run what they do well.
Here's Williams straight ahead. And able to push the pile and muscle his way to the 15.
He's very, very good.
Etling on third down and 8 in trouble, but able to escape. Etling's got running room and dives for the first down marker and will be close.
He's got to be a relentless competitor, making plays like that all the time in practice.
3 more points for LSU after the defense. Samuel takes a knee. It'll come out to the. Jackson to the air here. And an uncorked one underthrown and batted away. Seth Dawkins. As they run Radcliffe here for about 3.
I think that Ohio State secondary is going to make a lot of plays tonight.
Jackson finds Staples for a first down. Pass mid had a lot of drops by his receivers. As Louisville runs it on first and 10. Radcliffe
against these high-powered spread attacks, which is what plagued Alabama in the past, but he'll absolutely dissect you with precision.
Jackson picks up the first down, scooting out of play. Go ahead.
Out of their comfort zone.
Jackson's throw on target.
One of the best so much.
J. Jackson leaves the pocket, throws incomplete. There is a flag, though. John Battle all over.
Pass interference. Defense number 26. This foul occurred in the end zone. The ball will be placed at the 2-yard line.
A lot of key playmakers.
Jackson tried the bootleg. Now in trouble. And throws it away.
Well, intentional grounding. Offense number 8. The quarterback was out of the tackle box. However, the pass did not cross the line of scrimmage. Loss of down at the spot of the foul.
Been with the bat all the while.
Complete to Seth Dawkins there. Here's third down and goal. Remember, this drive started on the 2. No touchdowns yet for Louisville. Jackson stood up at the 4. It's a shovel pass, and they're not going to get in. Leading Louisville 29-9. Here's the 24th carry of the day for Darius Geis. Well over 100 yards, has 2 total touchdowns.
For 58 in the neutral zone, causing the offense to react. 5-yard penalty, 2nd down.
It's a belief.
Brent Musburger and Sean Farnham this year. Geis on 2nd down.
Canada's offense next season.
Well, they get Darrell Williams back next year as well. 230-pound running back. As Etling dumps it off for a 1st down to Deshaun Smith.
Today getting in a sense of a rhythm.
A lot of that is the offensive line is Bryce's
game, and he did so many good things over the course of the year. He can continue to build and grow and become a more complete player. He'll be unstoppable.
Darrell Williams picks up a yard. Louisville and 202 yards of total offense. 3rd and 10 here for the Tigers. They called timeout just before they got a delay of game penalty, and they run Williams. He's up to the...
In the NFL draft, he is so good and makes it so difficult on corners and one-on-one coverage.
How many of those Alabama dudes on defense will be first-round picks, you think?
Can I say plays? Something to build on, for sure.
Lamar Jackson just throws it away there with...
Best players in college football, obviously, calling the shots at quarterback.
Jackson fires to Dawkins. Season would have gone if they would have won that game to start the year. Here's Jackson taking off, fumbled the ball. That's been a problem for Lamar Jackson of late. He gets a 1st down, but then he...
Look, I've worked it more this year than I ever have as a head coach, and yet it's still been a problem. Big point of emphasis heading into 2017.
Good run by Darrell Williams, picking up the 1st down of the 40s. As you see in our bottom line, Dalvin Cook, to no one's surprise, announcing that he is going to the NFL draft.
Cook. Linebackers for the LSU Tigers.
They give up 217 yards today, a season best for the LSU defense.
You get to go work with Bill Walton. I know that you're excited about that.
I'll just lay out. LSU beats Louisville 29-9. First win officially for Ed Orgeron.
They got him good with that Gatorade bath. Well done. This season could have gone one of two ways. Could have gone south 2-2 at the end of September. Ed Orgeron righted the ship.